Hello students, in this video we will discuss velocity and acceleration analysis of slider crank mechanism by first analytical and second graphical method. And velocity and acceleration analysis of slider crank mechanism first by analytical method and second by graphical method. Velocity and acceleration analysis of slider crank mechanism. First we start analytical method. First we draw the slider crank mechanism diagram. This is crank first we draw the diagram of slider crank mechanism this is crank Draw a horizontal line. Then we draw the connecting rod. This is connecting rod. This is slider. This is fixed surface. This is slider. This is connecting rod. The length of connecting rod is L. Length of crank crank radius R, this is slider, and crank rotates at angular velocity omega. Omega, this is angular velocity R at angle theta. Then d theta by rate of change of crank angle d theta by dt, this is equal to omega. When it is clockwise, then minus डी थीटा बाई डी टी इक्वल टू ओमेगा व्हेन दिस इज क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन एंड प्लस डी थीटा बाई डी टी इक्वल टू दिस इज फॉर एंटी क्लॉकवाइज Now this is O. Suppose this is C and slider P. So this is slider crank mechanism. The crank rotates at constant angular velocity omega. The slider it reciprocates in which direction? It reciprocates in horizontal direction. Now this radius r means crank radius r, the length of connecting rod is l. Now point O, this is fixed point, then the distance from O to P This is fixed point O, the distance of P which vary with time, suppose this is equal to x and let the angle CPO, suppose this is equal to phi. Now the location of slider from O, we can write draw a perpendicular from C to OP. Suppose this is D, then x equal to the displacement or distance from O, x equal to OD plus DP, R this is equal to OD equal to R cos theta and DP equal to L cos phi, R x equal to R cos theta plus L cos phi, and the relation between theta and phi from trigonometry the relation between theta and phi is the CD equal to we can write R sin theta, R CD equal to L sin phi, R sin phi equal to R sin theta divided by L R sin theta upon L by R, then sin theta this is equal to sin phi equal to sin theta by n, where n equal to the length of connecting rod divided by crank radius r, n equal to l by r. generally L by R, the range of L by R, which is between 3 to 5. So the equation 2, now cos phi equal to under root 1 minus sin square phi, or this is equal to under root 1 minus sin square theta by n square, means cos phi equal to under root 1 minus sin square theta divided by n square. Now put the value of cos phi in equation 1, let this is 3, then the displacement or distance of slider from O is x equal to r cos theta plus L. Now cos phi equal to 1 minus sin square theta by n square, means x equal to r cos theta plus L under root 1 minus sin square theta by n square, and L equal to, we can write L equal to nr, then x equal to r cos theta plus n into 1 minus sin square theta by n square. So this is the displacement of slider. Now velocity of slider Now velocity of slider Vp, this is equal to velocity of slider Vp equal to, it can be written as Vp equal to dx by dt or dx by d theta into d theta by dt. Now d theta by dt, this is angular velocity of crank and the velocity or the direction of crank, it is clockwise, then d theta by dt equal to minus omega, then it can be written as Vp equal to minus omega dx by d theta or minus omega d by d theta, and x equal to r cos theta plus n under root 1 minus sin square theta upon n square. Now, differentiate with respect to theta. Differentiate with respect to theta. Then Vp equal to velocity of slider. Vp equal to minus omega r. Now, cos theta, differentiate with respect to theta, this is minus sin theta, minus sin theta plus minus 2, differentiate with respect to theta, so 2 sin theta into cos theta divided by 2 under root n square minus sin square theta r minus minus plus omega r into sin theta plus 2 sin theta into cos theta equal to sin 2 theta upon 2 into under root n square minus sin square theta. तो लीनियर वेलोसिटी ऑफ स्लाइडर देन द वेलोसिटी ऑफ स्लाइडर वीपी इक्वल टू ओमेगा आर साइन थीटा प्लस साइन टू थीटा अपॉन टू अंडर रूट n square minus sin square theta. This is the velocity of slider. This is very important relation. Now, as n is usually 4 to 5, as n is usually 4 to 5 or 3 to 5, means the value of n and sine theta always are equal to 1, in above term under root n square minus sin square theta, the value of sin theta always less than or equal to 1, then the under root n square minus sin square theta, this is equal to n. Then approximate value of velocity of slider, this is equal to omega r sin theta plus sin 2 theta by 2n. This is approximate velocity of slider. If n is very large, now, if n is very large, then Vp equal to omega r sin theta as simple harmonic motion. So velocity of slider Vp equal to omega r sin theta plus sin 2 theta upon 2 under root n square minus sin square theta. Now the angular velocity of connecting rod. Angular velocity of connecting rod. So from equation 3 or equation 2, what we are going to find out angular velocity of connecting rod. Angular velocity of connecting rod, which is d phi by dt. Now from equation 2, from equation 2, sin phi equal to sin theta upon n, from equation 2 sin phi equal to sin theta divided by n. Now differentiate with respect to t, we get cos phi d phi by dt equal to cos theta by n d theta by dt. Now crank rotate clockwise, then cos phi into d phi by dt equal to cos theta by n into minus omega. Then angular velocity of connecting rod d phi by dt, it can be written as minus omega cos theta upon n into cos phi, or cos phi equal to, this is omega cos theta upon n into under root 1 minus sin square phi, and sin square phi equal to one minus sin square theta upon n square r. Angular velocity of connecting rod d phi by dt or d phi by dt equal to minus omega cos theta upon under root n square minus sin square theta, where theta is crank angle and n equal to L by R. So this is angular velocity of connecting rod. connecting rod and angular acceleration of connecting rod, which is d square differentiate with respect to t of angular velocity d square phi by dt square. This is the angular acceleration. Then d square phi by dt square, it can be written as d by dt and d phi by dt, or d by d theta d phi by dt into d theta by dt. Now this is rotating clockwise, then angular acceleration of connecting rod d square phi by dt square equal to, now d phi by dt, substituting minus omega cos theta upon under root n square minus sin square theta, and d theta by dt, angular velocity of connecting rod crank, then this is minus omega because it is clockwise direction. Now simplifying, the angular acceleration of connecting rod, let this is alpha connecting rod C, then alpha C equal to, simplifying we get minus omega square sin theta into n square minus 1 upon n square minus 1, n square minus sin square theta power 3 by 2 if we simplify or differentiate minus omega cos theta upon under root n square minus sin square theta, we will get n square minus 1 upon n square minus sin square theta power 3 by 2. So this is angular acceleration of connecting rod. This is important relation. And this is angular velocity of connecting rod omega connecting rod C. This is also important relation. Now next, the acceleration of slider now acceleration, this is equal to acceleration of slider, this is equal to rate of change of velocity R, AP equal to velocity differentiate with respect to T आर डी वी पी अपॉन डी थीटा इंटू डी थीटा बाई डी टी, देन एक्सेलरेशन ऑफ स्लाइडर ए पी इक्वल टू डी वी पी अपॉन डी थीटा इंटू माइनस ओमेगा. नाउ वी पी इक्वल टू ओमेगा आर इंटू साइन थीटा प्लस साइन टू थीटा अपॉन टू इंटू अंडर रूट एन स्क्वायर माइनस साइन स्क्वायर थीटा आर डी बाई डी थीटा ओमेगा आर इंटू साइन थीटा प्लस साइन टू थीटा अपॉन अंडर रूट एन स्क्वायर माइनस साइन स्क्वायर थीटा इंटू माइनस ओमेगा. इफ वी कैन नेग्लेक्ट दिस साइन स्क्वायर थीटा देन सिंपली ए पी इक्वल टू ओमेगा स्क्वायर आर दिस इज अप्रोक्सीमेट वैल्यू साइन थीटा अपॉन साइन टू थीटा अपॉन टू एन. नाउ वी डिफ्रेंशिएट इट तो एक्सेलरेशन ऑफ स्लाइडर ए पी इक्वल टू ओमेगा स्क्वायर आर इंटू कॉस थीटा प्लस कॉस टू थीटा डिवाइडेड बाय एन. तो दिस इज द एक्सेलरेशन बाय मैग्नीट्यूड, दिस इज प्लस एंड माइनस. देन लीनियर एक्सेलरेशन ऑफ स्लाइडर ए पी इक्वल टू प्लस माइनस ओमेगा स्क्वायर आर कॉस थीटा प्लस कॉस टू थीटा बाई एन. This is important relation. If the mass of slider, let the mass of slider equal to m, then the inertia force m into AP, then Fi equal to inertia force Fi equal to m into omega square r cos theta plus m omega square r cos 2 theta divided by n. Then this is the inertia force due to the linear acceleration of slider. This is also very important. Then the important relations. first equation. This is important. Second important. Third important. Vp equal to important relation and angular velocity. This is also important. And linear acceleration, omega square r cos theta plus cos 2 theta divided by n, and inertia force. This equation it will use in balancing of reciprocating mass. So Fi, it is two parts, inertia force of reciprocating mass means slider, it have two parts. Part one, m omega square r cos theta, and second part, m omega square r cos theta divided by n. This is part one, this is part two, means inertia force part 1 and this is part 2. The magnitude which is m omega square r, and in second part m omega square r divided by n. So this is the primary force first, and this is secondary inertia force. Okay, now next the analysis of velocity and acceleration analysis of slider crank mechanism by graphical method. The next is graphical method. So first we draw the velocity diagram, then acceleration diagram. So with example, the slider crank of slider crank mechanism rotates clockwise at constant speed of 300 rpm, means speed of crank, this is equal to 300 rpm, and the length of crank means crank radius, it is given 150 mm. Length of connecting rod L equal to 600 mm, and crank angle 45 degree, with inner dead center means theta equal to 45 degree. Determine velocity of slider and angular velocity of connecting rod, acceleration of slider and angular acceleration of connecting rod. Now first we draw the diagram with scale. This is O. Draw R equal to 150 mm at 45 degree. This is R equal to 150 mm. Some suitable scale, and then draw a horizontal line this is 45 degree, this is hinge point, this crank of radius r equal to 150, then l equal to 600 from this center. Draw a arc of length 600 rpm. This intersect at, this is the arc, this intersect at this point, this is P. Join C and P, join point C to point P, then this is slider, this is slider, this is 45 degree, and the speed are the direction of crank rotation. Suppose this is left, anticlockwise. Now, given the speed n equal to slider, crank, mechanism. Okay. Now, linear velocity of point C. Linear velocity of point C with respect to O linear velocity of crank pin C with respect to O, then VC equal to omega into R, where omega equal to 2 pi n, n equal to 300 rpm divided by 60 multiply by radius 150 upon 1000 meter per second, and this is equal to VC equal to VC equal to 4.713 meter per second. Now, we draw the velocity diagram. First, the total number of lines we have to draw. The first is the velocity VC, which is perpendicular to OC. Second, velocity of slider VP, the direction is known but magnitude unknown. The total lines, line number 1, first line, we have to draw first line, direction and magnitude both is known. Second, draw perpendicular to CP, a line perpendicular to CP and passing through C, and third line we have to draw VP. Now consider a point This is the point draw VP. Which one is VP? The line 1 first is VP. This is line first.
line second and the line third. We have to draw the three lines, line 1, line 2 and line 3. Line 1, direction and magnitude which are known. So this is velocity Vp and equal to 4.713 meter per second to some suitable scale. This is fixed point O. The second line, the direction of slider, then direction. This is horizontal. Now third line, which is perpendicular to CP. This point is C. Now third line, which is passing through point C and perpendicular to CP. Passing through C and perpendicular to CP. Now this length, measure this length. This is the velocity of slider. This is P and the CP, this is a relative velocity of connecting rod CP. Now the velocity of velocity diagram. Now with the help of this diagram we can calculate Vp, V, Cp, already known Vc, direction and magnitude. With the help of this diagram we calculate radial acceleration, radial acceleration. The radial acceleration and from this diagram Vcp equal to Vcp equal to 3.4. This is equal to 4 and Vp equal to, it is given, sorry, Vp equal to 4 and Vc equal to 4.713 meter per second. Now radial acceleration of, now direction of accelerations, the total line which we have to draw, radial acceleration of OC, radial acceleration of OC, radial acceleration of connecting rod ACP transverse acceleration, then the linear acceleration of slider AP, this is linear acceleration of slider. So there are total number of lines 1, then draw 2, then draw 3, and then draw line 4. Magnitudes of acceleration already calculated from velocity triangle, radial acceleration of AC, radial acceleration of connecting rod, and unknowns are transverse acceleration, means transverse acceleration AT of connecting rod. These are the unknowns. Now start the acceleration diagram. So first we calculate the radial acceleration of crank, which is OC radial acceleration, which is equal to VC square upon OC. Put the value of VC, 4.713 square upon OC equal to 150. Then 150 upon 1000. Similarly, radial acceleration of connecting rod CP radial, this is equal to VCP square upon length CP. VCP equal to 3.4 square upon CP equal to the length of connecting rod equal to L equal to 600. Calculate this. Now start drawing of radial acceleration diagram. So first consider a fixed point O, reference point, then draw the radial acceleration of crank . This is AOCR, radial acceleration, with suitable scale. This is ACR. This is line number one. Then next, the second line ACR, this is along the direction of connecting rod. This is the radial acceleration of connecting rod. This is radial acceleration of crank. Then draw perpendicular to this line, means line number 3, which is perpendicular to CP. This is perpendicular to CP. Only direction known, magnitude unknown. Now, next, draw line number 4, R, linear acceleration of slider P. Now, this intersects at this point. So, this is the acceleration of slider P. Measure this distance. This is transverse acceleration of CP. Radial acceleration of CP. Both are perpendicular. And this line, this represents the resultant acceleration. This is resultant acceleration of connecting rod CP. So, this is the acceleration diagram. This is acceleration diagram.